Hey guys, it's Christine, also known as Ivy Winter. Thank you for joining me for another Disney video. This was a requested video asking about buying a ticket for Disney World through a third-party vendor. What are the pros and cons? When should you buy through them? When should you buy direct? So I thought this was a great question that I wanted to address in a full video because I think a lot of people planning come across these third-party ticket vendors and one, aren't sure if they're legit, and two, aren't sure how to utilize them, how they work, are the discounts worth it? So we're gonna talk a little bit about all of that. First, before I even start, I need to say to be careful about where you buy your tickets. When I talk about third-party vendors, I am specifically talking about like the deals through like AAA, if you're a member, or like undercovertourist.com. There are so many scams out there for tickets. I made an entire video about this that I'll link to just in general about being careful about this kind of stuff, and it goes more in depth, but I always wanna put a disclaimer or just like a warning out there. Never buy pre-used tickets, partially used tickets. Never buy tickets off of eBay or Craigslist. And just remember that if a deal looks really too good to be true, it probably is. If it's like a crazy discount, I would double check before you actually make that purchase. So I just wanted to put that out there first. What I'm talking about when I'm really thinking about it is undercovertourist.com. I can vouch for them. Even Disney has said that yes, they are a credited third-party vendor. They are a trustworthy website. So that's kind of what I'm thinking about when I'm talking about buying outside of Disney for the rest of this video, but it can apply to AAA. I believe there's something like Maple Leaf or something is the name of another one that's also accredited and good. But just so you know where my brain is at, that's the site that I'm thinking of. So first and foremost, if you're buying a one-day ticket or a two-day ticket, I wouldn't buy third party. You aren't really gonna get any discount. In fact, I don't think that they really give discounts for those tickets. You're better off just buying direct with Disney, whether it's through the website or at the park. So I just wanna put that out there first. But when you're buying tickets that are multiple days, that's when the idea of a third party might make more sense. One thing that I want people to keep in mind when they see the discounts on these sites is often they say, this is the discount versus gate price. And then you might be comparing your ticket on Undercover Tourist to the Disney World website and say, huh, this discount doesn't seem that big. It doesn't seem to be the $40 they're saying I'm saving. That's because they're comparing it to, like I said, gate price. What you pay at the gate is more money than what you pay if you buy it early at Disney. So that's how they're looking at discounts. So it's a little confusing and you wanna make sure that you're understanding what they're saying, because plenty of times, I just did it with my friend Nikki who came in January. We were trying to find the cheapest way for her to buy a ticket and we were comparing Undercover Tourist to Disney World and the discount was like a $5 difference, and yet they were saying you were saving 30 bucks, which was confusing. And then we realized that meant she was saving 30 bucks if she went up to the gate the day of and bought a ticket. So just keep that in mind. So of course, the more days you buy, often the higher the discount overall that these sites can give you. For non-park hopper, they usually say $50 to $60 per ticket. For park hopper, it's a little bit more, which is like $70 to $80 per ticket. This is just because of the percentage that they can give off of the cost of the ticket. Something to definitely look into whether you're solo or not, but obviously the bigger the group you are, especially if like you're paying for all the tickets for your family, you're gonna see a lot of savings if you're buying four or five tickets at once. Before you buy that ticket, definitely consider prices for packages straight from Disney World, which basically means you're getting your hotel and your ticket together, or separately, because sometimes they give deals on an actual package, and if you do the math, it's actually gonna be cheaper for you to just get the package through Disney. I feel like getting the best deal here is gonna take some time to do some of the math. So look at that first before you even decide to go through third party. If you're staying on property, one, you might want to check and see what the package deal is like at Disney, because it might end up being cheaper in the long run. But if now you've decided, yeah, okay, I'm doing hotel separately and tickets separately, then you've got some other things to consider with working with a third party. One, you know, you can't really take advantage of things like dining packages. Disney wants you to buy the ticket direct through them to get like free dining or discounted dining. So if that was something you're interested in, you can't do it with a third party ticket. Just something to think of. And then if you buy third party, usually with undercover tourists especially, there's two different ways they can send it to you. One is by mail, so you'd have to consider the fact that it would have to go through snail mail to get to you, and you get a physical ticket. And then the other way is an e-ticket, but it can take up to 24 hours to get to you. And I have 100% heard of stories where people said, yeah, it took the full 24 hours. So it's not necessarily a purchase you want to make if you know you're gonna be going to Disney World like tomorrow and you don't have a ticket ready yet at 10 a.m. when you wanna be in the parks. Like, consider the fact that third party is not instant. And so if you need something quicker, you might as well just buy through Disney. Also, something to consider is that e-tickets are non-refundable. You get an e-ticket, that's it, it's sent directly to you, you cannot get your money back. If you get a physical ticket, they are refundable, but only if you don't yet connect them to your account. But that's just another thing to consider. You know, some people, non-refundable is not a big deal. You know that the trip's gonna happen, you're not looking to change anything, but refundable as an option is always good. So I think that you wanna consider that if you're debating on an e-ticket or a physical ticket. So do I think that third parties are worth it? I think, again, you got to do the math. You know, when we looked at it with my friend Nikki, it actually did not end up being worth it, and the $5 difference didn't really matter to her, and she thought it'd be easier to just do it through the Disney website, and then everything would be connected with all of us. But for sure, I mean, there's some people who swear by it, and that's the only way that they buy their tickets, is through third party, so they can save a few dollars here and there. So definitely take a look at the site, definitely do the math, see if there's any discounts directly from Disney on packages that might make more sense. Crunch some numbers and then you'll know what makes the most sense. I would love to know in the comments below, do you buy through third party? Something that you've done before, was it a great experience, bad experience, somewhere in the middle, or do you prefer to just buy through Disney Direct? Let me know in the comments below. If you like this video, then like it. If you like me, you should subscribe. I make videos every single week, and I appreciate you guys watching. Thank you so much for tuning in, and have a great rest of the day.